Unless you are not an African or live under a rock, chances are you've heard about the story of Okoro Blessing, the Nigerian Instagram blogger who lived a fake life on social media until she got busted. Well, she has officially apologized to Nigerians and her fans across the world after she was humiliated for claiming someone else's house as hers. But people still refuse to take her seriously, not after she made this weird video.
Put up your face. I go fuck you up. You want to spoil my car? Come up here, put up your face. Monyang, do you know who I am?
Hello guys, it's Noeline here for African Glitz. Wealth is a terrible drug that often pushes people to do terrible things beyond their means. Okoro Blessing is a good example and will stand to be corrected. The blogger and mother of two got caught and shamed on social media after she posed and claimed someone else's house is hers. She even went as far as dragging ownership of the house with the rightful owner by providing false documents of the building as well as continual video of the building. The original house owner, who goes by the name Onyeze, is a China-based Nigerian businessman. He had to quickly fly back to Nigeria to prove that he is the real owner of the house. Upon his arrival, Okoro Blessing was still claiming that the house was hers. It got to a point Onyeze had no other choice but to call the police on her. As we can imagine, it didn't end well for the blogger. She got humiliated and shamed on live video.
You say that this house does not belong to you.
This video now we are talking now. Nobody will post
your case.
Just in case.
This house does not belong to me.
Who does this house belong to? Onyeze, who?
Onyeze
and Achimko. What did you do that made them to ask you to say the owner of the house?
I recently came here to take a picture.
You recently came in here to take a picture?
Yes, sir.
A picture of Onyeze, Abi? A picture of Onyeze? A picture of Onyeze's house?
Yes.
And you say that Onyeze is a rubbish human being,
I've
right?
Never said that.
To cut a long story short, she was later released. She also spent some time with Onyeze over a drink. Fast forward to 2 days later, Okoro Blessing made another video threatening to commit suicide over the incident, but she wasn't taken seriously by Nigerians and her fans. The blogger in her video did not accept any wrongdoing. She did not apologize to her fans or Onyeze, but selfishly complained about how humiliated she feels.
A lot of things has gone wrong and I'm asked to keep quiet and not say a word except they are going to kill me. But one more it is to die than what they have done to me on the internet. That the world feels I did something wrong. I would rather prefer to die and tell my story than die being quiet for nothing. I was not arrested by any police officer. No police officer handcuffed me and humiliated me. It was the Onyeze that sent his boys. I was invited to his house. They called me on the phone and told me that he wanted to see me. Stupidly for me, because I had nothing at the back of my mind, I just took my shower, wore my gown, and went to his house.
Fast forward to a week later, she finally made an official apology on her Instagram page, asking for forgiveness and blaming the cause to her action to public pressure. However, the 30-year-old mother of two still claims she is building a house, but wasn't able to finish it, hence why she decided to present someone else's house for a cover-up. Trust Nigerians, while a few accepted her apology, others still believe she is not sorry from the sound of her sarcastic apology. Majority of people advise her to take a leave from social media, among other things. Just a few days ago, she made another video titled A Message to Her Ex-Husband. This time, she dragged one of her kids along with her to yet another uncompleted building. wearing the same outfit she wore on the day she was arrested by Onyeze. People on social media found this rather awkward, some insisting that she really needs professional help. Is Okoro Blessing putting on art? Or she desperately wants to be famous? Maybe she's finding the best way to cover the shame she brought to herself. She comes to social media every other day to make another weird video on Insta story. One good advice the majority of her fans and people are suggesting to her is to live her truth, because she doesn't owe anyone any explanation. Besides, no one cares if she is building a house or not. We really don't know what she is going to come up with the next time. We wish her well and hope she gets the help or break she needs. Do you agree with members of the public that Okoro Blessing should stop the lies and live her truth? Do you think Okoro Blessing will carry on living the Slay Queen life? Well, let's talk about it on the comment section down below. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button and share. Also, don't forget to follow our page for more African trending stories. No clickbaits, no lies, just facts. Thanks for watching and see you on our next one.